श्री वैष्णव प्रसाद मोहंती, द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द फंक्शन, वाइस चांसलर ऑफ द सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ ओडिशा प्रोफेसर सच्चिदानंद मोहंती, हेड ऑफ सेंटर ऑफ मास कम्युनिकेशन यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ राजस्थान प्रोफेसर संजीव बनावत, डायरेक्टर PRCI श्रीमती गीता शंकर, प्रोफेसर उपेंद्र पाड़ी, डिग्निटरीज, डेलीगेट्स, स्टूडेंट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आई थैंक एंड कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट द इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मीडिया स्टडीज ओडिशा एंड पब्लिक रिलेशन काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया फॉर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग द नेशनल पब्लिक रिलेशन कॉन्क्लेव and express my sincere gratitude for having invited me to the wonderful function and giving me an opportunity to address the august gathering. The organizers have given me 30 minutes to speak. I don't want to test your patience. I am not a media expert. I am not a PR expert. It is just my feeling which I will try to share with you. Before becoming the chairman of the press council, the only subject on which I used to speak and speak very loudly were the freedom of the press and safety of journalists. I have been always a firm believer that free media is not an option in democracy, it is sine qua non. If people are the heart of democracy, the media is the oxygen that keeps the heart beating. Democracy can flourish only and only when press or media is allowed to function freely, fairly, objectively, and independently. In a sovereign country, media is the voice of the people, and a nation that responds positively to the problems of the people alone can grow and prosper. The Press Council of India, since its inception, has been engaged in the task of safeguarding the freedom of the fourth pillar of democracy by adopting a mechanism that deals with complaints or any incident of violence on media person with the help of the journalistic community. I must say that to a certain extent, the council has successful in achieving its objective of creating an atmosphere where the press breathes. As Professor Mohanty has said, wherever I go, the first question which is put to me is, do you regulate the press? And my answer is that regulation is a very dirty word. The professionals do not like it. They want to be regulated by themselves. And my answer had been that the Press Council of India is to preserve the freedom of the press. And I have said it times without number that if the press freedom is not there, perhaps the country will not survive. I went to the extent of saying that an irresponsible press is better than a controlled press. When the press is irresponsible, the people have materials to judge, as to whether it's right or wrong, but it is control. There is nothing before you to judge. And therefore, ideally, there should be an irresponsible press, but when you compare, I believe it's better than a controlled press. As all of you know, the essential function of the media is to create mass awareness in the society and help people formulate opinions, may it be choosing the right political party to form the government, the right healthcare system, or right financial services providers, or even the right educational institutions. You see, in many of the newspapers and the magazines, they rank various institutions from 1 to 10, 1 to 20. I have received a large number of complaints about that, that those ratings are without any basis. There is no objectivity to it. But fact of the matter is that that guides a common man in choosing an institution or health service provider. The power of media, as you said, can build your image like a Mahatma or diminish your image like a monster. And it is said that it is for this kind of a influence the media has that you need a public relations officer, a public relations professional. I can drive home my point by a lifetime story. There was a young leader. He, from the hostel, he goes to the assembly. Because of his commitment to the people, he was made a minister. The minister goes to the airport. It was not an airport where there are aero bridges and all those things. The passengers used to be carried by buses. The minister was waiting. The public relations officer of the airlines asked the minister to wait. He was waiting. After some time, he was left alone. And the airlines decided to take him by a car. Generally, they ferry the passengers by bus. The young minister goes to the aircraft by a car. And next day, the news item is the minister refused to travel in bus along with the common passengers. This minister was greatly opposed to the appointment of a public relations officer. He said, "My life is open. Why should I engage a public relations professional?" But the next day, when he saw this in the newspaper, his senior colleagues advised him to have a public relations officer. After a few weeks, he has to go as a minister, he has to travel from one place to another. Exactly the same thing happened. He was ferried from the airport to the aircraft in a car. And the next day, the news item comes. The minister was suffering from fever, a particular fever that's called dengue. And he did not want to travel with other passengers because that could have infected those passengers. And the public welfare is so primary to him that he chose to travel by a car. Same incident, a public relations officer and without a public relations officer, that's you require a public relations officer these days. But the question is, what is meant by public relations? How you define it? Somebody talked about the Radia incident, and therefore, by whatever means you achieve the target, is it that public relation or the means or the end, this everlasting debate will go on. According to me, public relation should be understood as a process that involves a deliberate, planned and sustained efforts to establish and maintain mutual understanding between an organization and the public, and it should be based on truth. There was a great mathematician, and he used to listen to various advertisements, particularly for the headache. And it was mind-boggling for him that every manufacturer of the medicine said that 70% of my medicine is used by the public. 70% people use my medicine. And he was wondering that 5-6 medicine manufacturers claim the same thing, and the mathematician got puzzled and then said that it's beyond my comprehension. I think what best has been said about public relations was by Edward L. Bernays. He is considered to be the father of public relations. Public relations attempts to engineer public support for an activity, cause, movement, or institution by imparting information, persuasion, and adjustment. India, as you know, is a vast country. Here, a vast country has different kind of problems. Its size, its population, linguistic, cultural, and religious diversity. And to drive home the point, in a society like India, public relations is must, particularly for the government, as it is accountable to its various politics, policies, and programs. Earlier, as I said to you, the public figures were averse to the idea of a public relations professional. Now they are not. The new leadership in all organizations, whether it's a government or private, are well aware of the importance of public attitude. Today's organizations and institutions, including the religious institutions, are all working with the motive to serve the interests of the people and focus on public relations for keeping the institution growing and flourishing. The public relation is considered to be an effective way to achieve milestones, a smooth relationship, and safeguard reputation, but it should not be viewed as the remedy for all ills. It is important to remember that public relations can only help when there is a matching performance. It is not composed of stunts or gimmicks, and it cannot afford to disregard ethics. A good practitioner of public relations should communicate any information with utmost sincerity, with accurate facts, and avoid misleading the consumers. the main objective of public relations professional should be to win the trust of the public and impart understanding that convinces the people to adopt a certain attitude or pursue a certain course of action. The public relations practitioners and journalists both have the power to influence public opinion. The freedom to express in public and influencing public decision that journalists and public relations practitioners mutually enjoy needs to be exercised sensibly, sincerely, with due care and caution. And if you, I was going through the Constitution of India. All of you must have gone through that. All of us believe that the Constitution of India consists of letters and words. And every citizen of the country uses one or the other article of the Constitution for its benefit. The public servants invariably invoke Article 311, Article 14, Article 16. The religious leaders invoke Article 22. But how many of us know that the Constitution of India does not contain only the words and the letters? The Constitution of India contains 46 paintings. And a state of Odisha should be proud that your scripture is in the original constitution adopted by this country. You will be surprised to know that the Constitution of India contains the paintings of Lord Ram, Lord Krishna, Guru Gobind Singh Ji, Mahavir, Buddha. Therefore, sometimes I wonder that many of the facets of the Constitution, which are not known to the people, the Constitution itself requires a public relations officer. Because when you talk about India is a secular country, and what do you mean by secular? Secular means that every Indian has the right to profess the religion in which he believes. When the original constitution, the paintings of the gods are there, what it symbolizes? Do you know the photograph at the beginning of the directive principle of state policy contains a painting of Ram Rajya? The Lord Rama is there, the goddess Sita is there, the Lakshman is there. Therefore, many of the aspects of the Constitution which must be propagated and must be known to the people should be highlighted. And for that day, I do not know, I thought this is the best place where I should speak about this, because you people are the professionals, the public relations practitioners. We must talk about those features of the Constitution also, which many of us do not know. We wish you the best for the conclave, and thank you very much for giving me a patient hearing. Thank you.